Hey you guys, and welcome back to Dark Souls. So, something's a little bit different. The Dark Knight has risen. Brienne of Bath. The Dark Knight has riven. Risen. I went back and farmed the rest of the Dark Knight stuff. There is one piece missing, which is the Dark Knight shield, which I do want. Because it's an absolutely amazing shield. But here's the problem. Even with some level ups, so where's my stats? There we go. I've got vitality now up to 24 and strength up to 28. So we're 2 points away from being able to use the Black Knight Ultra Sword, but even with our vitality risen 3 points, we are still at 73. Percent weight ratio up there in the top right corner, and that's having unequipped the shield I was using. So, which means we're still fat rolling. It has to be below 70 to not be fat rolling. So where's my dragon crest? There it is. And we are going to downsize a little bit. That gets us to 75. And probably the legs will be what to change at this point. 70. What gets us under? You do. Training shoes. Training shoes. Am I still fat rolling? I am not. Okay, great. So that's what we'll do for the meantime. So the task is to get 30 strength and then just pump every other little level we have into vitality until we can fast roll wielding an ultra sword, a great shield, and a full suit of Black Knight armor, because that's Brienne's way of doing things. Now we're going to travel. We're going to go back to the bonfire we were at in the previous episode, and the reason for this is that you'll remember I picked up a key in the chest in the sewers. And we never used that key, and the reason we never used that key is because we had to come back here to use it, and in order to use it, it helps us get certain other things. You're dead. That's nice. We're just gonna skip over most other folks because we're only here briefly, or we should only be here briefly. Excuse me. It like tried to backstab except missed. You saw that animation, I know you did. So we come through here. And then there was this cage here? No. No, no, no. One of them. One of them up here is locked. Might be on this side. And it gives us access to another key. Okay, it's not there. Where are you? Excuse me. Nope. These guys have surprisingly long reach. A Crystarats mask. Let's put that on, shall we? A Crystarats. I know it's Aristocrats. So that puts us over, so we're not going to wear it. I will wear it briefly because it looks silly. Mask worn by jailers of the Urithil dungeon, noblemen delighted in the plump features. The jailers were among the few survivors inhabiting the profaned capital, later serving under Pontiff Sullivan. Perhaps the screams emanating from the cells helped them forget their old home. This is what we look like if we wore it. Very silly. We have this big shawl that comes off the back of us. It's pretty neat, actually. But we're going to go back to Thief Mask. And back to our big old sword. Right. Excuse me. I'm being very... And now I'm... This is purposeful at this point. I'm being very, lazy about playing at the moment. Because I'm only here briefly. It's locked. We got the old cell key. And I could have swore that was the step we needed to take. We haven't come up from here, because I know where that is. Maybe I am misremembering things. Okay, well, let's go to the profane capital, and I'm going to work my way backwards. Because I want to try that old cell key on another door. And perhaps I was misremembering. I remember you had to... What I remember was that you had to open a cell up there once you got an old key. And that old key let you get another key that was in that cell that let you open another cell. But saying that out loud makes me realize how silly that might have been. So perhaps not. Perhaps not. And yes, we will have to fight the gargoyle again. Although I suppose we could probably try and ignore him. Since we'll just be running back the other way. There he comes. There he is. Hey buddy, old pal. Are you gonna... No, you're not gonna bother me. That's nice. We will have to deal with jailers though. Yeah. I hate dealing with jailers. They're just like 100% the worst. Can I like get one of their attention? Just you. Pomp. Come here. You can't see me. I can't see you. Well, I can see you now. You're not gonna come after me, are you? I'm right here. Come on. Oh well, okay, we'll try and another way to do it. You absolutely have to die. Remember, we're definitely ignoring the cell behind us, because the cell behind us leads to horrible things. It's a trap. Open. It's locked. Yeah. So, there is another key that I'm missing. As I suspected. But maybe I am extra wrong. And the key that I need is in the profane capital. So we will press forward. We will in fact press forward, and we don't actually have to deal with the gargoyle this time, because I can just do that. Right. So, let's charge forward into this unknown landscape, shall we? The profaned capital. It's a pretty confusing layout, actually. You have two ways you can go, and I will climb back up here as laborious as it is to show you. You have... Get up ladder. There we go. You have this way. You can see the tippy top of the ladder here. And you also have that way. We're going to go that way. The down one. Because the other way leads to a boss. And we are not interested in the boss right now. We're interested in other things. This way, however, is completely optional. You don't technically have to do this bit. But we are. We definitely are. If we take a look around, you can see. These guys have some sort of shoulder-mounted cannon. If memory recollects, this probably is inspired by ancient Chinese fire sticks. But that's getting way too meta about where the sources of concepts come from. But basically I'm saying that they're ancient guns, which is pretty neat. Hello? Hello? Ah, there you are. Hi, friend. Hey, how are you doing? Oh, good, I see. Doing quite well. What the... Why am I punching? Why is my character punching? I know why my character's punching, because I had this in one-handed stance rather than two-handed stance. So if I try and use the shield button, I'll punch instead of block. And I meant to block. But I shouldn't be blocking anyway. I need to change my habits because we are in non-shield territory right now. And I should be trying to roll more often. I normally do roll, as you guys know. It's just, that guy is pretty scary. There he is. How you doing? Rolly poly. Oh, don't fly backwards. That's really annoying. Come here. Come on. I'm gonna smack you. Stop. I demand that you stop. Oh. Oh. Is that how it's gonna be? Also, I forgot to change to my Estus. Here we go. Right. Play nice, Jeffrey. Jeffrey the firestick toting gargoyle. Here we go. My brain got there. That's what I wanted to do. That's what the was for, by the way. Was me remembering. During the middle of the fight, I realized that I wasn't embered, and I want to be embered. I always want to be embered. We haven't seen any PvP, actually, since that one time in the swamps. Despite me being embered literally all the time. So this guy is a tricksy creature, right? You can't see it very well, and that's entirely on purpose. But that crystal lizard is on the other side of a pit. I am going to jump the pit. Dang it, me. I was completely failed. Well, not completely failed. I suppose I managed to jump the pit properly. You can hear that horrible stuff. It's because there's those hair spiders down there. There's a long way around here, which is safe. Which has another crystal lizard. Who gives me more twinkling titanite? Yes, please. Yeah. Alright. So two crystal lizards down. You can go the long way instead of jumping over the pit. But the pit is how you get. And I forgot about that pit. So there we go. Now I'm in a real deep trouble. And it's not actually because of the hair spiders. It's because of what just flashed up on the screen just there. Toxic. Toxic. No good. Toxic bad. We need to get out of here. Come on, hair spiders. They are all around here and it's horrible. Get out of my life. I have enough Estus to make this happen, but... Right. That was unintentional. I didn't mean to come down here quite so soon. I think we missed out on one item above. Which is not an important item, but, you know, in the spirit of the Let's Play so far, I've been collecting everything that I can. So should probably aim to continue to do that. We have Toxic, which is Poison plus plus. It's awful. You can see how fast my health is decreasing. And it's just horrible. You don't want it. And there's only one kind of item that gets rid of it. You can't use the same stuff that gets rid of poison. You have to use Blooming Moss Clump, which I think there's one up on that thing up there. But so we're gonna have to just drink Estus all day. Which is not what I felt like doing, but we do what we have to do. We do what we have to do. Okay. Let's grab more items. Kill more hair spiders. And head up here. Normally what you'd do is you'd jump off that pier. It's called a pier. onto that little island of land there and run right across here, and you'd avoid being intoxicated. But we did not avoid that, so we're stuck down here. I could homeward bone back and just do the whole thing all over again, which I'm very tempted to do. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. And the reason I'm gonna do that is because I don't want to spoil this experience. I'll go back. Because otherwise it's gonna just be chugging Estus and avoiding doing fun things. And if I was to continue on, there's a particular objective I want to get done at that point. From that area, and that's what I would have done, actively chosen to do, and then just avoided everything else. But there's a lot of stuff down there. Let's just avoid this guy. You don't actually have to fight him. He can't follow you, so why bother? This time, I'm going to remember that there's a pit at the top of these stairs. And in the spirit of this tiny little crypty type place, it's actually a long way around. That's the item we missed out on. Bastard gold coin. Cool. And here's that pier I was talking about. And at the end is that blooming moss clump. Yep, memory is on point today. Look at me go. So, normally, roll off, run in, keep running, roly-poly, roly-poly, and you're not toxic. You're being chased by hair spiders, but they can't do nothing because they can't climb ladders despite having many legs. You'd think many legs would help them climb things. It doesn't. So instead, we're going to fight Big Hand Man. He's called Big Hand Man because he is a giant hand. There he is. These guys are horrible. They're horrible because they don't get affected by your slashing. As you can see, he just keeps doing his own thing. Also, they're just kind of disgusting in nature. Trying to sit on me. Wow. Alright. You finally hit me. Good on you. You're dead, though. You're dead, son. They drop poop. So if they weren't disgusting enough already, they're even more disgusting. They drop poop. Sorcerer Court. Or what? Brain? Court Sorcerer Hood. Sorcerer Court. Okay, read things backwards. That's fine. Court Sorcerer Robe. Robe worn by court sorcerers of the profaned capital. The formal gold stitching suggests that they may have also been oracles. There are many sorcerers who claim heirship to the great Big Hat Logan, and the profaned capital houses one of two leading schools. There you go. Big Hat Logan. It's, I think I've mentioned before when we were talking about the crystal sorcerer dude we fought many moons ago, was a very famous sorcerer. That is a mimic, clearly. And this is how we deal with mimics. We cut him up. Slicey, slicey. Thank you for being a part of my experience, Mimic. Court Sorcerer Staff. I don't know whether that says anything different, but that staff is really important for sorcerer characters. Go figure. Catalyst used by court sorcerers of the profane capital, very powerful when wielded by exceptionally intelligent sorcerer. The court sorcerers laid claim to the legacy of the renowned Big Hat Logan, going so far as to emulate him with copies of the staff he used. It did have special lore. Look at that. Go game, go. Down here is pretty much nothing. It's really weird. Including rubbish. Which is worth less than nothing. And I think it's worth one soul. And this room has nothing in it. And never has. It's very weird. But let's continue on. We're not done here. We have to come out here and go up these stairs. And get our way onto the roof. And then we fight that guy. Who's basically just a giant horrible jerk. But if I can get close enough to him, he's not as much of a horrible jerk. Alright. No. So, he has a very interesting sorcerer weapon. Wow! Which is actually a decent melee weapon. But he's dead anyway. And we get Logan's scroll for our trouble. Lots of Big Hat Logan lore around here. And you can probably imagine this was the sorcerer's school itself. So Logan's scroll. Where are you? Where are you? Logan's scroll. Here. Secret Scroll of the Profaned Capital Court Sorcerers, containing sorceries of Logan. Give to a sorcerer to learn Logan's sorceries. The court sorcerers use the scroll to claim heirship to Logan's legacy, though how they claim stands up to closer scrutiny is another story. So, we're still not done up here. I'm gonna grab this. Oh, hello here, spiders. Whoops, I went over that. I can't even remember what that was. Was it this? Was it something in here? Oh my god, I'm gonna have to review the footage now. I'm not actually gonna review the footage. I'm too lazy for that. So, whoops. I do know what that was. I do know what that was. It's a spell. How do I get to my spells? Emit force, right? That was it. Or is this the thing that I was thinking of? Oh, that was it. Wrath of Gods. Okay. Well, I don't know what that thing that creature was holding. Wrath of Gods. Wrath of Gods is an epic tale, while Force is but a woefully incomplete version of the yarn. This one. This primal account of profound fury emits a shockwave that also inflicts damage. So it's a damaging version of this, and it goes in basically a sphere around the caster, if I remember correctly. Which is nasty. So, we're going back up here. We're not going in there. We are going in through there. Hey! Oh, alright. I was pretty sure that was accurate, but okay. Whatever you say, game. And jump. There we go. That was less accurate and I made it. So, this leads to our friend Onion Knight. That's what the old cell key was for. Hey, Onion Knight.
Ah, you are a saint. Once again, you are my valiant savior. I, Siegfried of Katarina, express my deepest gratitude.
Yeah, dude.
Take this, a token of my thanks. Go on, it's all yours.
Thanks, dude.
Ah, no, please. Go on ahead. I've my own road to take, and a duty to fulfill. That is soon. Ah, no, please.
Okay, well, you have fun. Covetous gold serpent ring. You can replace the silver ring with the gold one. Or we can have both. But I really like my rings, so I'm just going to replace the silver one with the gold one. Gold one increases more than the silver one does. Same job, more stuff. So, now that we've let Siegfried out, we're going to go up here. Sigvid. This is a horrible trap. So, notice how this room is completely empty, right? Nothing here. Nothing at all. But if I go down this way... keep going around. Is this... Jailer's keyring, that's what I was after. Now all those locked doors are openable to us. Oh, hi! Hi, jailers. How'd you get here? Doesn't matter, you're both dead. That's a horrible trap, though, if you don't know what to expect. I don't know how they get there, because there's no way in from here. I think they just spawn in. Oh well. And as you probably noticed outside, is that other giant. Which we may as well try and kill now. It's very annoying. He has rats at his feet. Which makes things awful. And what makes these rats even worse is these particular rats keep respawning. They come out of these holes in the wall. But we are going to wake up Mr. Giant and try and murder him dead. Doesn't that sound fun? And hopefully he will kill the rats for us. Because he's exactly the same as the other giants. And the best place to fight these giants is at their feet. Because they can't do anything about tiny ants like me. As you can see, the rats just keep spawning and spawning and spawning. And they will do so, I believe, until the giant is dead. And we have a friend over there, I think. Whoa, 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 whoa. I am taking an awful lot of damage. Good thing I didn't really use any Estus. And these days I have plenty of Estus. So that's nice. I'm just gonna go ham. There we go. Dead giant. Dead rat. Large titanite shard. Titanite shard dung pile. There's a dude standing there. I swear there was. Profaned flame. Large titanite shard. Cool. So that's all that stuff. I told you we'd come back here. And Ty was honest. So profaned flame. That's why you do that. Pyromancy deriving from the profaned flame engulfs foes at range and burns them to ashes. The profaned capital was consumed by fire after Yorm the giant became a lord of cinder. The fire, born of the sky, is said to have incinerated naught but human flesh. Does that mean it burned everything except humans? I think that's... or... it says humans, but for some reason I feel like that means... only the living survived? Since the profane capital was actually a... an undead settlement. That's how I'm going to choose to interpret this. So we could have come here a long time ago, and the reason I didn't is because there's kind of no point. But leads to this door, which leads back to the original bonfire in the Aerithal dungeon. Alright, let's go open some jail doors, shall we? So the first one is the one over here on our right. But I'm going to kill you first. You're a pain. And I don't like you. Jealous here. Are you screamy? Be prepared for screams just in case. Not screamy. Thank you very much. That's jail door number one. Stop it. You as well. Not even gonna give you a chance. That's right, I'm prejudiced. I'm prejudiced against the undead. Even though I myself am undead. Does that make me a traitor, I guess? Alright, so jail cells. I think there's one downstairs here, which wasn't openable. It might have been the other side, though. I just want my health to come back. And I'm going to leap on your head. Sorry about it, bro. Got a smoldering iron and a jailer's robe, which is pretty neat. Let's take a look at those. Now that I'm not surrounded by cages of bodies. Jailer's robe. The jailers were among the few survivors inhabiting the profaned capital, later serving under Pontiff Sullivan. Perhaps the screams emanating from cells helped them forget their old home. So that's the same as the hood. And what about the smoldering iron? Soldering iron. Branding iron used by the jailers prowling Erythal Dungeon. Press its searing tip against foes to inflict fire damage and temporarily block Estus healing. Okay. So, that sounds really good, right? Like, preventing people from healing. But the actual iron itself does next to no damage. Which makes sense, because really the jailers don't do all that much damage either. Unless they get you in the grab that they have. But you can't do the grab, so oh well. Prisoner Chief Ashes. We've got a couple of ashes to hand in, actually, now that I think about it. So we should do that. And the final one that we want to access is... Yeah, we'll go this way. Excuse me, boys. Go around here. And down here. And this way. It's gonna be tricky getting across the courtyard. Where's the lever? There's the lever. That was obviously an accidental Estus. Pay it no mind. Any day now. There you are. I find it interesting in Dark Souls that the monster positions reset when you sit at a fire, but elevator positions never do. I suppose you could argue that the reason that doesn't happen is because they're not living. Elevators don't live, and only living things reset. If you want to go far enough in trying to find an excuse for the game. Nope, denied. I know you want to, but you can't. So, in we go. They're following. Nope, they're turning around. That's very nice of you. So, this person's pretty fun.
Oh, there you are. I thought you'd all but forgotten me. How sweet. Good to know that a skinny little heretic can still turn heads. Hmm? Oh, you're not one of them, are you?
She thought I was one of her jailers.
Accept my apologies for mistaking you for one of those leeches. So, what business have you here? This is a land of monstrosities. And I am no exception.
Bum bum bum.
You're here to save me. But I'm guilty. A wretched child of the abyss. Is that something you can forgive? Oh, really? You are no ordinary woman. Very well. Besides, I've grown tired of imprisonment. I am Carla. And I accept your proposal.
So Carla, as we will find out, is a dark pyromancer. Is that what they're called? I think it's what they're called. One of our scrolls will tell us. Not in here, they won't. Maybe we haven't picked up any dark pyromancers so far. Which is strange. I could have sworn I picked some up when we went down into Demon Land. Excuse me, jailers. I will be ignoring you. So we are officially done with Earthel Dungeon. Whoops, I meant to take that to heal me. However, I forgot it's my maximum health that's damaged, and not my actual health. Right. So we're just gonna activate Mr. Gargoyle here. And honestly, I'm just gonna do this. And then I think to cap off the episode, we'll go have a chat with Carla, huh? Which I could have done with a homeward bone now that I think about it, but oh well. All's well that ends well. Right, Carla. So, she's not specifically down here. Right, that's just his body. For some reason I thought there was an item there. Let's talk to Thief Man, because we haven't talked to him in a while.
Oh, hello. Fine work, I say. Discovering Irithyll in the Boreal Valley all in a day's work. If the tales are true, it is home to old moon-worshipping nobles and should be packed with treasure. What do you think? Shall I go and see what I can find?
Yes.
A fine choice. I am Grey Rat the Thief. What I bring back will be worthy of that name.
You go do that, Grey Rat, and I am so thankful for your services.
Goodbye. Do stay safe.
Thanks, my dude. But here is Carla. She's picked a really odd spot.
Ah, there you are. As I said, I am Carla. And am grateful to you. Now, what shall we do? The only thing that might interest you is my sorcery. Although my dark arts are a detestable sort, that wouldn't interest you, would it? You're a wicked one, aren't you?
Ooh.
Very well. Humans are of the dark. And you are no different. Some may avert their eyes, but the truth remains the truth. Be careful, though. Few humans are privy to this knowledge. Let it be a secret, kept between you and I.
I think I've explained to you in the past that that much is true when I explained the origins of this game when compared to Dark Souls 1, that humanity was born of the Dark Flame. We'll give her a pyromancy tome.
Oh, a pyromancy tome, have we? And one that resonates with the dark. Yes, well suited to me. Very well. If this is your wish, I will unravel the thing the best I can. Besides, it will be nice to play master for once.
You'll remember that pyromancy tome, and now I recall too where our dark pyromancies went. That our pyromancy master that we already have refused that tome when we offered it to him. And the divine tome that we're going to give her now is the one we got from the scary evangelist who was mumbling to herself in the Boreal Valley.
Oh, is this a divine tome? What on earth are you thinking? I wouldn't go near a divine tome or any so-called miracle.
Whoops.
And casters of miracles are sure to steer clear of me. So please, don't torture me so.
One of these is bad. Is it the Londor one?
Oh, you. How could you?
Have I insulted you?
Oh, I know. I know. I owe my life to you. Fine then. But just this once, I will tell you this tale. But do understand, it will be my first time. I'll have no sniggering should I err.
Yeah, odd. Seem to remember her being able to give you those sorceries, and it looks like she can. I just didn't remember her being quite so offended. So we'll look at dark sorceries, which we now have access to. It appears to be an expression of envy, or perhaps... Whoops, I should probably start at the beginning. A forbidden dark sorcery casts a dark manifestation of humanity. It appears to be an expression of envy, or perhaps love towards another, that will tenaciously pursue its target, even if, like so many human desires, it amounts to nothing but misfortune. So now you start to get an idea of how tragic the human condition is in Dark Souls by looking deeply into the lore of things like these, in particular these spells. A forbidden dark sorcery strikes with a blade formed of humanity's darkness. Passed from mother to daughter, this blade is intended for both protection and as a means of taking one's own life. The young girl never swung it more than once. Pyromancy discovered by grave wardens after High Lord Volnir fell to the abyss. Creates a giant black flame in hand. Black flames born from the abyss bear no shadow. They are said to be the impenetrable fires of humanity. Pyromancy discovered with grave wardens after High Ward Volnir fell to the abyss. Hurls a black fireball. The black flame inflicts dark damage, striking targets with a weighty force. Miracle of the Sable Church of Londor reinforces right weapon with dark. The third daughter of Lilian, one of the founders of the Sable Church, is said to recount tales that portray the suffering and conflict of the Hollows. And Vow of Silence, Miracle of the Sable Church of Londor, prevents spells in vicinity, including one's own. Members of the Sable Church are trained swordsmen, each sworn only to their weapons as they bear the leaden silence of Londor. And finally, Dead Again, Sacrilegious Miracle of the Sable Church of Londor, bless corpses, transforming them into traps. Londor the Hollow Realm is a society of undead, comprised of the corpses and shades of those who led unsavory lives. Is such blessing really something one must ponder? Yes.
Do stay safe.
Londor was a big deal in Dark Souls 1, but that is Carla. She is creepy and pretty cool. And we are going to spend this last level, and then we will have to say goodbye, my
Welcome
friends.
Home. I should speak then. Very well, then take them.
And we will put that in strength and let it be done. Cool. We only need a couple of thousand more to reach the next level. Do I have that in any capacity? I do not. Alright. Well, I guess we'll get those couple of thousand souls next time. So, thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye!